Hello and welcome to a very special Monster Hunter World Let's Play. I'm Casey DeFreitas and today I'm joined by Executive Director of Monster Hunter World, Kaname Fujioka.
Hi, Kaname Fujioka.
And the Localization Director, Andrew Alfonso.
Hello. One of the localization
One
directors.
Of them.
There's a lot of localization directors. So.
A lot of them. Yep. And he's also going to be interpreting for Fujioka-san today.
Yep.
And we also have Yuri, who is playing Monster Hunter World today for us. He is the community manager of Monster Hunter and has been around for a very long time. Thank you for being here, everyone. I am super excited to have you. Fujioka-san has been working on the Monster Hunter series since the very first, so I'm especially honored to have him. I've been playing since the very first as well. I'm excited to jump into Monster Hunter World with them. So I know we're now in the Coral Highlands looking for Paolumu. Mm. And if you look at the... Oh, there's a Legiana. if you go back into the Collector's Edition and look at the concept art, it looks like Paolumu could have been a duck-billed platypus. What made you go from duck-billed to cute, fluffy bat monster instead?
So basically, when they were planning the monster design, the original idea for the monster was a balloon-like flying wyvern.
Mm-hmm.
They were looking for something that was fuzzy, mm-hmm. so they felt that maybe the platypus look was not good. Maybe something a little bit different was better. So that's how they came up with the final design for the monster.
その時にデザイナーからアイデアがあって、その結構こう首というか顔がこうバルーンみたいに膨らむっていうのを、デザインで取り込もうとしたんだけど、その時に、いろんな顔のアイデアがあった中で、そのハムスターというか、げっ歯類のこうハムスターとかがこうここに蓄えてほっぺたをプッて膨らますのとすごくその風船みたいにこう膨らむっていうのがデザイン的にすごく相性が良かったので、カモノハシみたいな顔もアイデアとしてあったんだけど、ハムスターみたいなああいうちょっと月種類の、顔つきをチョイスしました。
So yeah, I guess the art designers on the game, they had a lot of different ideas for what kind of monster this should look like. And since they were looking for a balloon-like monster, one of the designs was something that had a little bit of a puffy cheeks, just like a hamster does.
Mm-hmm.
So they were like, okay, this kind of works because this is kind of like what we were going for with the body and everything like that. So they decided, okay, instead of going with the platypus look, we should go for this more hamster-like look because it looks more like a balloon when you take into account the face and the body at the same time.
ふさふさのね、このバルーンみたいになる、
は
い、真ん中にこうポツンって顔があるのがすごい可愛いかなと思って、はい。
So yeah, they felt like, he had the, you see Paolumu, he had that, balloon-like, sack there where his, body was really expanded, and just having that little tiny little face there, mm-hmm. in the middle like that was super cute. So mm-hmm. okay, we're gonna go with this.
そういう感じで、design.
And that's how they came up with the final design mm-hmm. for Paolumu.
Mm-hmm. So we have a fan from Facebook, Christian Bruno. He asks, how long does it take to create one of these large monsters like Paolumu from inception to completion?
ちょっとユーザーの質問なんですけど、開発。うんでは、うん、コンセプトから最後まで何ヶ月くらいかかるか、う
ん、あモンスターの
そうモンスターの
これモンスターにもよるんですけど、ネルギガンテとかいう、 こう看板になるモンスターとか、あとアンジャナクとかああいうモンスターはすごく長い時間かけて作ります、うん、特にアンジャナクとかはこう挙動の検証から作ったので、もう1年ぐらいかけて作ってるし、こういったそういうベースが決まってきたら、だいたいデザインコンセプトから制作で実装までだいたい半年からぐらいかな。
So it really depends on the type of monster that they're designing, especially for, I guess what you can say that we call them in English the flagship monsters, monsters such as Nergigante, and especially another monster like Antrinath, because those monsters could take up to a year because it's so important to the actual game.
Mm-hmm.
But once you get the base of the game, base of the monster done, it usually takes about half a year to develop one monster. But a lot of the more important monsters will take a little bit longer than that.
How many concept designs will there on average be for one monster?
一つのモンスターに対して、コンセプトミニチュア、何枚が
何枚
出ますか？
何枚ぐらいあるかな。なかなかこうアイデア出ないやつはめちゃくちゃ出るんですよ。やっぱり10枚とか20枚とか出て、その中からこう組み合わせ的に良さそうなのがあったら、またそこから絞って、またそこからアイデア出して何十枚とか書くんで、本当に50枚とか出る時もあるし、結構あこれいいねってパッと決まるやつは結構早くて、やっぱ 2,3 枚書いたらアイデアがこう結構もうみんながあこれだってなるんで、結構モンスターによってばらつきが。
Yeah, that also really depends on the type of monsters. Sometimes, you know, monsters don't get right away and they only need like two or three concept images to really nail down the design. But if there are some monsters that are like, you know, they're really having a lot of trouble with coming up with, you know, a nice design for, you know, they'll come up with maybe 20 or 30 images.
Oh, wow.
But then, you know, they'll take those and they'll, you know, kind of like pare it down, but then they'll go back and be like, okay, well, we have even more ideas for these, you know, pared down images and come up with maybe even more, you know, ideas. And then the number could rise to maybe 50 sometimes. So yeah, it really depends on the type of monster and like, you know, how difficult it is to design, you know, one of these monsters.
Has there ever been a heated argument between which concept they would go with?
コンセプトのイメージを、決定するときに、すごい喧嘩が喧嘩というかね、
議論
議論ですね、議論ですね、議論したことはありますか。
そうですね、まあなんかそうだね、どっちがいいかなって悩んだりとかして、こうちょっとなかなか決まらないことはあるけど、まあデザイナーがこういうことやりたいっていうのと、僕がもっとこうあるべきだっていうので、ちょっとまあそういう議論はね、常々あるので、ただやっぱりコンセプトに基づいてこうデザインを決めていくので、まあ喧嘩はないけど議論は常に。
He's not gonna call them heated arguments. He'll call them discussions.
Okay.
Yes, that's the best way to put them. Yeah, they do have like, you know, these kind of discussions about which one's better, because sometimes the designers would say, you know, I want to do this with the monster, but Fujioka-san will say, well, you know, this is what we should do with the monster, and they'll have their back and forth, and you know, it always happens during development. So yeah, they do have, you know, these kind of.Quote-unquote discussions when designing a monster.
So Josh on Twitter, at Quack306, asks, what comes first, the level design or the monster design?
じゃあ、開発するときに、レベルデザインなのか、モンスターデザインなのか、どっち先に決めるか。
そうですね、どちらかが先っていうのは明確には実はないんだけど、まあ、今回は特に生態系をしっかり作ろうっていう、まあ、コンセプトを基づいて作ってるので、やっぱりどういったまずモンスターたちがどういった環境に生活しているのかっていうのはすごく、最初に決めないと、モンスターの方の今度生態系が決まってこないっていうのがあるので、まあ、そういう意味ではどういったフィールドにしていくかっていうのはまず今回は決めました。
So basically, there's not really any set rule for which one comes first. I guess for this, for Monster Hunter World, because they were, you know, thinking about, you know, how all everything kind of ties together in this really nice, ecological system. They were, you know, they had to figure out, okay, we have these kind of monsters. You know, what kind of, you know, ecology would they, you know, be living in and whatnot. So they had to decide, you know, basically.That kind of stuff first. So before they could, like, you know, really, you know, focus on the monster. So I guess for this end, you know, they focus a little bit more on, you know, what kind of environments that they lived in first. Yeah.
この今ユリがプレイしてる丘サンゴとかも、まずその丘サンゴっていうものがすごく群生してる場所っていうのを決めて、そのモンスターたちが何をまず食べて、そこにこうどういうピラミッドが、まあ、生態系のピラミッドがあるのかっていうのをまず考えていくときに、その モンスターが一番最初にこう、まあ、小動物とか小さな動物がまず食べるものっていうのをまずイメージするんですけど、まあ、このオカサンゴの大地の場合はオカサンゴが産卵する卵をこう、食べにまず小動物が寄ってくるっていうのを、まあ、この生態系の一番底辺のピラミッドにしようっていうふうにまずデザイナー、デザインしていく。
So, in particular, for example, the Core Highlands, which is the stage that Yuri is playing on right now, you know, they wanted to figure out, okay, how exactly does this whole, you know, environment work? They wanted to talk about, you know, the food pyramid and, you know, figure out, okay, what is it going to eat what and where, you know, where are the monsters going to get nutrients from and whatnot. So, you know, they figured, okay, in this environment, you know, there's all these, you know,vital, I guess, lush, you know, lush plants and flora and everything like that. And they figured, okay, well, they're going to eat these, like, you know, these eggs that are being spread across the stage. And this is how the monsters get their nutrients from. So this is, like, so that formed, like, the basis of, you know, where they're going to go with the monster design.
で、そういった時にその、まあ、オカサンゴが産卵するために、すごくその環境をどういう環境にするかっていうので、そのすごくその上昇気流の強い場所、風がすごい強い場所でこうオカサンゴは卵を産むので、まあすごくこうそれが広がって群生するっていう生態系をまず構築して、そうなってくるとこう上昇気流の強い場所に生息しているモンスターのデザインっていうのが、まあ、どういったものだろうかっていうので、このハオルムとかはそういう風に乗ってふわふわ動くっていうのが結構その独特な動きになるので、まあ、そういったあのモンスターのゲームデザインが出てくる。
So again, for example, like now you have these, you know, they decide, okay, all the monsters in this stage are gonna be, you know, they're gonna have nutrients based on these eggs that you can find in stage. But then they figured out, okay, well, now we want to know how do these eggs get, you know, scattered around the stage? And they figured, okay, we're gonna have, like, you know, these nutritious eggs.Floating around the stage by a very strong wind current.、
Mm-hmm.
So they figured, okay, now that we have this, okay, we can have monsters like Paolumu who can also, you know, maybe utilize the same kind of currents that are in the stage. And this is how they came up with, you know, these kind of different designs, because they based everything on the ecosystem of the, you know, each level.
That's one of the things that I hypothesized the first time I saw Paolumu, is he puffed up his neck.Oh, you probably use the updrafts that you find that you can use with your glider mantle.
そうですね。なんかパウルムを始めた時に、まさかこのステージの風を利用して、うん、いろんなところに飛んでいくじゃないかと、うん、彼女が思います。
うん、ああ、そうです。そういうのをまあ、なんていうか感じてもらえるようなコンセプト、まあアートもそうだし、生態系デザインっていうのを。すごく意識して作っているので、まあ、すごいそういうところが伝わって、嬉しい。あ、
ユーリ、
ユーリ、ユーリ、
ユーリ、
come on,
man. ユーリ。Yeah, Fujioka was just saying right now, like, yeah, this is that was actually what they were aiming for. They wanted you to, you know, kind of feel and understand, like, everything like this is connected. And that was, you know, the main, I guess, one of the, I guess, important things in Monster Hunter World thatYou know, there's this living, breathing ecosystem that you feel part of, and everything's connected. You just look at the monster, you look at the environments, and you can tell how, you know, everything is related.
なので、まあ、オカサンゴの、一番主、主になっているそのレイゲーナっていうのも、風をこうコントロールするというか、風に乗って自分をこう素早く飛ぶっていう能力が長けてるモンスターがこのステージでは主になる。
And that's also one of the reasons why you have a monster like Legiana in this stage. Legiana takes advantage of like the incredibly strong wind currents in stage so that he can go from place to place extremely fast. And it's one of the, I guess, trademarks of the monster.
Yuri が油断したらやられそうですね。
Yeah, Yuri, he's saying that you're not paying attention, you're going to die really quickly. So you gotta...I'm sorry, I'm gonna have to say it, but you're gonna have to get good, man. Come on.
Talking and listening to conversation and playing this game is very difficult. I did it with Nergigante, and it was... I almost died many times.
プレイしながらなんか話聞くのがすごい難しいです。
ああ、そう。
確かに、ユリさんがね、ちょっと
集中できない。
集中できないです。
はい、そうですね。結構ね、アクションゲームだからどうしてもこう、 日が散りながら遊ぶとやられちゃう。
Yeah, if you're not paying attention, this is a night game, so if you're not paying attention, yeah, you're gonna get. Oh, there you go.
終わってきた。
Come on, Yuri. It's a little bit more.
So I did. I'm really glad that we are here、with those the blue spots on the floor.、Mm-hmm. So、earlier, Yuri.Used explosive damage on it and it made the Halumu sink into it and it kind of made splashes.、Mm-hmm. What inspired that environmental trap? Because I had no idea it would do that.
この青いのところなんですけど、モンスターをダウンさせるとなんか沈んでいくですね。だからこのデザインはどうなんか最初からどう考えました？
このオカサンゴ自体が結構まあも一番最初がそのなんていうかな海底みたいな海の中みたいな、うん、アートが上がってきてまあもちろんその海底じゃないのでそれをうまくデザイン陸としてデザインしないといけないんだけどまあその土台になってるこのオカサンゴの土台になってるものがそういうサンゴとかイソギンチャクとかその海底の、生物のこう土台にするのはどうだろうかっていうのでああいうちょっとなんていうかなこう生物的なものを、まあ土台にして結構水を含んだああいうこうトランポリンのようなものをこうベースにしてそこでこうちょっと足を取られたらそこに沈んじゃうみたいなものをこうアイデアとしてはい。
And when they were first making the coral highlands, they kind of base everything off, you know, what would be existing in a vast ocean. That's the kind of look they were going for with this stage. And, you know, they kind of thought about, okay, you know, you would have these kind of, you know, plants in the ocean, but, you know, what if we had them, you know, up in higher ground without any water? And that was one of the, I guess, this is also one of the concepts where they had for the stage where, you know, you have this, like, little lily pad that kind of goes up, bounces up and down, but...You know, if you put too much weight on it, you kind of sink into it a little bit. And yeah, that's where it came from. Just, you know, studying the ocean and, you know, everything that's living in it and trying to figure out how we can use that in our stage.
So I know Yuri is using the light bow gun and the bow guns have had a rehaul, basically. Mm-hmm. And Luis Rodriguez Otero from our Facebook page asked, there's a lot of subtle improvements in Monster Hunter World, like reloading while moving. What brought on these little but significant changes?
まあ、今回のモンハンで、うん例えば 4U と比べると、うんすごいゲームシステムを改善したり、うん、書いたりするんですけど、はい改善したいところをどう決めたんですか、うんうんうん、
まあ、モンスターハンターってもともとそのなんていうかな、すごくユニークなゲームデザインをしていて、まあ、そういうところをすごいファンが大事に思ってくれてるっていうのは僕たちもすごい意識してるので、まあ、そこは絶対守ろうとモンスターハンターらしいところは必ず守ろうっていうのをまず、決めて制作をしてたんだけど、まあ、今回グローバルで展開したいっていうことで、やっぱいろんな、まあ、新規のユーザーの方もかなりその多く、入ってくるだろうというのを、まあ、まず想定して考え始めました。
So we know that, you know, Monster Hunter is an acne, but it has, you know, a lot of fans, right? Mm-hmm. And, you know, the most important thing for Fujioka-san and the Monster Hunter team is to make sure that our existing fans are happy and they are satisfied with the game. But also, because with Monster Hunter World, we're going for a more global audience, we also realize that there are going to be a lot more new users coming into this game for the first time.
そういった、まあ、新しく入ってくる人たちっていうのは、とにかく特にその何て言うかな自分たちまあファーストパーソンシューティングとか、まああいったそのスタンダードに自分たちが慣れてるゲームデザインっていうのがあるじゃないですか操作とか、うんまあ、そういったものをでなるべくその違和感のないような形でその自分たちが大事にしてるゲームデザインまあモンスターハンターとしてのゲームデザインにこう到達してほしいって思いがあって。うんまあ、そういった、到達しやすくそういうゲームデザインに到達しやすいように、まあ、いろんなところを改良していった感じです。
Yeah, so we do realize that, you know, there are a lot of gamers who are coming in for the first time and they might be, you know, used to a certain type of control. For example, you know, like first person shooter control or third person shooter controls. And you know, we wanted to make sure that those kind of users would be able to get into our game without having to, you know, having this long adjustment time. You know, they'd be able to jump in really quickly and enjoy the game. So, you know, we kept that in mind with our game design to make sure that, you know, we could you know, satisfy our current fans, but also make sure that new people who are coming in are potential fans without, you know, would also be able to enjoy the game.
So we just talked about the changes for the bow guns. Mm-hmm. Were there any other changes to any of the weapons that you feel was a quality of life improvement? Mm-hmm.
まあ、ボウガン以外の武器に関しては、
はい、
改善、
うん、
改善点というか、
うん、
他の変更がありましたか、う
ん、はい、まあ、もちろんあのいろんなゲームデザインを見直していったときに、まあ、武器ジャンルも一つ一つやっぱり見直さないといけないポイントっていうのがたくさんあって、でただその、重たい武器だから、じゃあこうクイックに動けるような要素を足していきましょうっていうのは僕たちは違うと思ってて、やっぱり一つ一つ武器に必ずその大事にしないといけない個性があるから、その個性を失わないようにいかにそれをよりそのなんていうかな、シームレスに、展開できるような、アクションシームレスにアクションができるような、デザインにしていくかっていうのをすごく考えて、
Yeah.
デザインしてました。
So for all the weapons, you know, we took them, I guess, one by one. We made sure we want to see what we can do with these weapons. And you know, it's not a matter of like, you know, this weapon is kind of slow moving weapon, so let's just add a fast attack to it. We didn't want to do that. We wanted to keep, you know, the, I guess, the essence, you know, mm-hmm. you know what this weapon is all about. We wanted to make sure that, you know, that got across to our fans. So we did add, you know, a lot of you know, little changes here and there to make sure that the you know, the action, all the combat is as seamless as possible for Monster Hunter World.
So Fujioka-san, the Takesmith on Twitter asks, what is your favorite weapon?
Fujioka-san の一番好きな武器は何でしょうか？
あ、僕はランスです。もうずっとランスしかむしろ使ってないです。
He likes the lance. He's actually only ever used the lance in Monster Hunter.
これからもランスです。
He's going to use the lance from now on. He's not going to change.
So we didn't have armor skills in the original Monster Hunter, but we have armor skills now. Are you an evade lance user or a guard lance user?
ちょっとあの、なんかランスのプレイスタイルの質問なんですけど、モンハン1に、まあ、防具のスキルがなかったけど、今回は、まあ、結構入ってるんですけど、
はい、
ランスの使い方は、まあ、藤岡さんのランスのプレイスタイルは、あの、回避する。
回避。
ランスの回避するスタイルなのか、
はいはい、
あの、ランスで、あの、ガードするスタイルなの、うん、どっちが、
ね、
どっちが藤子さんのスタイルですか？
僕はあまりガードで固まるスタイルじゃないです。
Okay. はい。So yeah, he doesn't really go for guards blocking all that often with lance. Yeah.
で、むしろ回避で避けるっていうスタイルでもないです。
And he's not really like a evade lancer either. He doesn't like, you know,Kind of like, you know, evade attacks and everything like that.
僕はとにかくそのモンスターの嫌なところにあのいわゆるポジション取りをするために回避を使って、モンスターがすごいあの嫌な場所、
うん、
モンスターがすごく戦いにくい場所にどんどん位置取りをしていって自分のペースをまず作っていって、うん、で相手がそのペースを変えようとした時に、そのアクションを見てカウンターを当てていくとか、そうやって自分のペースをこうペースを維持していく、
うん、
プレイスタイルです。
Yeah, so Fujioka-san's playstyle is, you know, it's more like a dancing style, I guess. He kind of dances around to where the monster is, you know, very weak. So he'll use the evades to, you know, kind of like get into position so he can attack a monster where it's, you know, favorable to him. You know, if the monster wants to kind of like, you know, change the tempo of the battle, he'll start using counter pokes, counter thrusts and stuff like that.But yeah, he's not really like a guard kind of guy. He's more like, you know, he's always moving.
Well, thank you for your lance tips.
Yeah.
Now, I want to go back to monsters, since I feel like we've talked about weapons quite a bit. Mm-hmm. Actually, could you tell us your favorite meal combination?
あの、一番好きな 食事なんですか。
食事。
このモンハンのこのワウのメニューに、うん、の中に。
メニューの中。
一番好きな。一番好きな食事。
まさかここで。
はい。定食は何でしょう。
なんだろうな。でもいつも僕あのおすすめおすすめ食べてったからな。なんだろう。なんだろうな。
He's always using
個人的にはね、野菜とか魚が好きだけど。
He's always going for the fish platter or the veggie platter.
That's what he likes.
はい。やっぱこうステータス見ながら選ぶから、このこれの中でっていうのはあんまり決めてないけど、まあ、個人的に食べるなら、
if he's actually going to eat something, it's going to be fish or vegetables. Yeah. But he'll usually, like, you know, look at the menu in Monster Hunter and figure out, you know, which ones are going to give him the best status buffs and whatnot, and then he'll go with that.
まあ、今回はでもあのディレクターの徳田が肉好きなので、もうとにかくビジュアルはもう肉がうまそうにするっていうのをミッションにやってました。
So yeah, actually the game is the game director Tokuda-san、he's basically a carnivore. He doesn't eat anything but meat. He loves his meat. He doesn't eat any vegetables. So he made it his personal mission to make sure that the meat in this game looks as tasty as possible.
I think he did a fantastic job at that.
まあ、あの、徳田さんのミッションがもう達成した。
そう、あの、徳田がすごい、あの、美味しそうだって言ってくれたんで、コンプリートです、ミッションコンプリート。
Yeah, so if, you know, one of the art, if Tokuda-san looked at the meat and, you know, he's like, oh, this looks so good, then yeah, mission complete. Yeah, I made him happy.
So one of the main processes of Monster Hunter World is hunting a monster over and over again so you can createawesome armor and weapon sets. And one of our fans, Jonathan Hernandez, asked, what is the in-game explanation as to how us hunters haven't driven all of the monsters to extinction yet, given the amount of farming we do?
まあ、あのモンスターハンターの、高サイトは、まあ、あのモンスターを倒して、うん、あの装備を作って、うん、そのことを繰り返すんですけど、
はい、
まあ、あのゲームの、まあ、モンスターハンターの世界のプロジェクトで、うんうんうん、あのなぜあのモンスターが全滅しなか、うん、まだしなかったんですか
全滅、ね、なるほど。まあ、みんなたくさんね、あの、討伐してますもんね。
Yeah, everyone is hunting a lot of monsters.
まあ、でも、あの、この世界って、まあ、あの、すごい真剣、真面目に答えていいのかな
He's going to give an actual serious answer for this, so...
I would love it.
あの、この世界って、まあ、人間とモンスターが、まあ、いわゆる共存してる世界なので、まあ、すごくその、いわゆるモンスターたちも、まあ、僕たちがこう虫を見るのと同じです。あの、アリをいくら殺しても、アリってめちゃめちゃいるじゃないですか。なかなか絶滅できないですよ、ね。まあ、それぐらいそのモンスター自体は、やっぱ生命力も持ってるし、繁殖力もあるし、しかも人間がやってることってその、まあ、その中での一部でしかないから、やっぱ人間の力だけでその、そういったものを絶滅させるっていうのは、よっぽど、まあ、難しいことだし、まあ、そういうことをやろうとしても、この世界っていうのはその竜人族っていう、まあ、ギルドがちゃんとその、そういう自然のバランスをコントロールしてるから、まあ、基本的にはそういうことにならないと思ってます。
Okay, so to make a long story short, you can't make the monsters extinct.、And、the reason why is because hunters and monsters,、to give a serious answer, hunters and monsters, they do live in a harmonious, you know, coexistence. So there are, you know, you might think, oh, we're killing a lot of monsters, but no, you're not really killing that much monsters.And the monsters don't really think of you as like, you know, a big threat. You're actually more like, I guess, kind of ants to them. So you don't really have like that important of an existence to these monsters. On top of that, you know, you have the guilds who are, you know, commissioning hunters to hunt monsters, but you also have the Wyverians in this Monster Hunter world. And, you know, they wouldn't take lightly to, you know, someone or something trying to, you know, disrupt the balance of,you know, monsters and humans. So, you know, driving a monster into extinction is not going to happen. It's going to be extremely difficult.
まあ、でもね、絶滅して、狩りができなくなったらみんな嫌でしょ。
Yeah, if you, and the thing is that if you, you know, if you drive these monsters into extinction, you can't make any more Monster Hunter games, so you wouldn't want that, right?
Absolutely not.
Yeah, so the more yatas.
So Puke Puke is one of the new monsters in Monster Hunter World. Mm. It gives you really great materials early on. A lot of the monsters actually give you really good materials early on. But what is your favorite new monster?
Puke Puke is新規のモンスターなんですけど、はいはい、まあ、新規のモンスターの中に、うん、藤岡さんの一番好きなモンスターは何ですか？はい、
そうですね、結構どのモンスターも魅力的ではあるんですが、まあ、今回 の, そのデザインアートワークの、すごいディティールにこだわれるっていうのがあったので、まあ、そういうデザインもそうだし、でモデルもそういうディティールすごいこだわって制作したんですね、うん、でそういうのを一番感じれるモンスターとして僕はバルハザクっていう今回新しく出たコリューがいて、うん、そいつのそのデザインとかディティールは僕はすごく作りがいもあったし出来上がった時すごいインパクトもあったし、うん、そのディティールがとにかくすごく出たので僕は大好きです、うん、は
い、So yeah, for all theBut a lot of the new monsters, they had a lot of work put into them. We put a lot of work and care into making sure they look super nice. And yeah, Fujiko-san and his team, you know, they spent tons of hours, you know, discussing how monsters should look and whatnot. But for Fujiko-san, I guess Fujiko-san, the monster that left the most impact for him was Valhaza, which is one of the new elder dragons in Monster Hunter World. I guess He spent more time than usual on that monster in particular. And, you know, when they, you know, I guess, when they completed the design for it, and when he took a look at it, he's like, wow, this is great, this is fantastic. So yeah, for him, that was the monster that he likes the most.
バルハザクのその瘴気が体からブワーって漏れるところを、まあ、もちろんエフェクトとしては出るんだけど、その、将棋が出るところそのシェーダーを作ってくれたんですよ。そのボディにこうブワーッと物が出るっていう。でそのシェーダーをねなんかそのモンスターにバッてかけた時にすごい迫力だったのよ。でそれがねすごいまあ、技術的にも面白いことができたし、まあ、そういったものをこう取りデザインとして取り込めてるバルハザクはやっぱりすごい僕は大好き。
So yeah, for Valhazak actually, when they're making the monster, they actually developed a new shader for the monster. And you can see it when he has the effluvium around him and when he shoots it out, that's actually the new shader that they made just for that monster. So when they apply it to the monster and you know, they turn it on and they took a look at it, they're just like, wow, this looks crazy, this is so cool and everything.And you know, from a technical aspect, they were really impressed with it. But also from a design perspective, they were like, oh, they were really satisfied with their work.
Hi.
So Valhazak, I was trying to figure out where I recognized his jaw from. Mm-hmm. Was there a fish that was inspired by?
Like a Valhazak の顎を見てみたら、ちょっとなんか実際の魚となんかと。見てるなと思いますので、はい、だからこのまさかこの魚を参考されたんじゃないかと。
はいはい、あれはウツボかな、ウツボか何かの顔、顎がこう二重になってるんですよ。あいつ口の中にももう一個口があるっていう生き物、まあ魚がいて、うん、まあ、それのねでディティールはすごいかっこよくて、でデザイナーの子はそれも大好きで、ちょっとこのまあ、最初そのバルハザクのちょっと怪しい感じを演出するためにそういう口の造形を入れたいっていうのを言ってきて、まあ、すごいそれがハマってたのでかっこいいなと思って、入れてもらいました。
Yeah, so there's actually a fish that has the same kind of like a jaw structure. So one of the designers he really really liked that idea. So you know he fooled around with it for a little bit. And I guess for Valhazak they wanted to go for something that seemed a little bit strange, a little bit odd. Like when you look at him, you're like, oh wow, this is really out there. And you know, having that, you know, kind of jaw, like, you know, attached to that monster really gave him that, you know, really, I guess you could say, really odd, unique look to him.
So you told us your favorite monster. If you had to be a monster, which one would you be?
あのモンスターになる、なるってあればどのモンスターになる？
モンスターになれるか。
なる。
なるか。なんだろうな。何になりたいかな。でもパオルムとかになれるとこうふわふわ浮いてたら気持ちよさそうだよ。
Yeah, if he was Paul Lumum, he'd be like, you know, all fluffy and fuzzy, and yeah, it looks like he'd be really comfortable, but look, feel really nice, feel like in a, kind of like in a blanket or something like that.
あのはい、気持ちよさそうなんでパオルムに。
Yeah, Paul Lumum definitely.
So if you're Paul Lumum and Odogaren comes by, what do you do?
じゃあのパオ、もしや藤岡さんがパオルムになって、うんうんうん、オドガランが出たらどうする？
そうですね。まあ、それは逃げますね。
Yeah, he's just gonna run away.
いじめられるんで、もう、オドガラン。
Yeah, オドガラン is just gonna... Yeah, in a certain way, he's just gonna, you know, bully him, so he'd rather not deal with that.
So I actually saw in the collector's edition art book that Odogaren used to have ears and a more dog-looking face. Mm-hmm. He actually is referred to as, like, man's best friend.Kind of in Monster Hunter World,、mm-hmm. why did you decide to take away the ears and kind of more、mm-hmm. dog-like features?
あのオドガランの最初のデザインではなんか、mm-hmm. 耳があったりちょっと犬っぽいと見えるけど、mm-hmm. ちょっとあの現在のデザインとその最初のデザインにちょっと離れてると思いますけど、mm-hmm. まあそのねあの変更というのか、mm-hmm. まあ、なぜそれで決めたんですか？
オドガロン自体が、まあ、結構あのシンプルな、シルエットにしようっていうのは結構最初の方から決まってて、まあ、素早さを売りにしたりこう爪の攻撃を結構特殊にしたいっていうので、うん、まあ、動かしやすい造形っていうこともあってこう結構シンプルなシルエットにしていったんですけど、まあ、その中であのそういった犬というか犬っぽいものが最初は出てきてました。はい。
Yeah, so basically,、so first of all, like,、they were trying to go for a more simple design with Odogaren. So, you know, they wanted to have like a really simple and easy to understand silhouette. And they wanted to emphasize that, you know, he attacked with his claws and whatnot. So that's why they,、you know, first went with like a more dog-like design.
まあ、開発のキーワードとしてもその正気の谷のそのまあちょっと番犬的な感じで、出そうっていうのも決まってたんで、まあ、あの開発名もなんか墓場番犬墓場番犬って言ってたんですね、うん、だからその流れちょっと犬っぽい顔が出てきてたんだと思います。
So yeah, when we were actually developing the game, Odogaren's code name was actually I guess called like the rotten to just literally translate it, it was likeThe Rottendale's like, I guess, like a hound dog, like, right? So, you know, they kept saying that, so that's why, you know, they were going for that kind of feel for him at the beginning.
で、その中で、ただやっぱそういうキーワードの中でこう犬の顔のままデザインを上げていくとすごい普通のこんな大きな犬になっちゃうので、あのやっぱモンスターハンターってライクに何かこうエッセンスを入れたかったんですね、うん、でその中でまあ、単純だけでやっぱ口とか牙をしっかりその顎の強さというか、まあ、そういったものをしっかり感じれるような、まあ、シルエットにもっとしていきたいっていうことでまあ恐竜でああいうその顎が大きな恐竜がいるんだけど、まあ、そういった顎の大きな牙が強そうで顎が大きい、まあ、そういったシルエットのデザインを取り込んでまあ、なんていうかな、モンスターハンターライクのデザインに仕上げてもらいました。
Yeah, so I guess one of the problems with the original design was when they took a look at it, you know, it looked kind of too much like an ordinary dog. So they wanted to emphasize different parts of it to make it more like a Monster Hunter monster. So, you know, for example, they kind of emphasized like the jaw, they emphasized, you know, different parts of the monsters to make it look different so that, you know,When you look at the design, you don't see like a regular dog. You see something that would, you know, is kind of like a little bit different, but still has that kind of familiarity to it.
Yes. Hi.
How do you decide on the colors of the monster?
モンスターの色をどう決めるか。
どう決めるか。
はい。
そうですね。 生息地が決まるときに、大体その、まあ、どういった生態を持っているかっていうので、やっぱり体の色ってそれなりにこう 理屈が出てくるというか、うん、ね、森の中に住んでるのにすごいこう、なんか、すごい、なんていうかな、こう、派手すぎる色って、なんか、こう、馴染まないじゃないですか。
うん。
まあでも、逆にその、自分、まあ、プケプケみたいにこう毒を持つっていうモンスターは、まあ、毒を持ってる生き物っていうのは結構蛍光色を持つ、まあ、警戒色を体に持つから、やっぱりカラフルにしていこうとか、うん、やっぱりその生態に応じてやっぱり色を持ってくるっていうことは多い。
They basically matched like、the monsters with the, you know, the ecosystem. So they kind of figure, they kind of decide, okay, well, this monster is living in this ecosystem, so it probably had this kind of color. So, for example,、if a monster is living in the ancient forest, it shouldn't be too bright, it shouldn't be too colorful. It should be a little bit more in line with the actual colors that they're using in the stage.Now, for example, in the case of Puke Puke, you know, that character, sorry, not that character, that monster utilizes poison as one of its attacks. So、mm-hmm. they figured, okay, it's using poison, it's gathering in its mouth. So that monster should have a little bit of a more colorful look to it because of how it operates、mm-hmm. within the ecosystem, within this world. And so that's how they usually decide on the color for each monster.、Mm-hmm.
あとは同じ色がやっぱ続きすぎると、まあ防具にした時も同じような色がやっぱり連続してしまって、ちょっとこうユーザーの遊びがこうバリエーションが出てこないというか、まあちょっと偏った色になっていくと面白くないので、まあ なるべくその、レベルデザインに合わせて、まあこう色のバランスを、まあなんていうかな、ばらつかせるというか、いうふうには考えています。
Yeah, another point also is that, you know, if monsters if there are too many monsters with the same color when you go and make your armor and your equipment, everything kind of turns out to be the same color as well. So, you know, that to the fans, that's going to be a little bit boring. You know, you're going to have like, you know, for example, everything brown or something like that. That's not really, you know, very interesting, right? So, you know, they also take that into account, like, you know, there is like, you know, a sort of a color balance within the whole cast so that, you know, you can strike, you know,this really cool like contrast between like, you know, one monster compared to another monster. You can see like how different they are just from their colors.
ネルギガンデとかもね、すごい強いモンスターにしたいって、パワフルで強いモンスターにしたいっていうことで、結構メインのイメージは黒色、まあ黒、強そうなキャラクターってやっぱ黒がすごく似合うので、やっぱ黒をベースにしようっていうのは決めてたんだけど、やっぱ何かこう真っ黒なだけじゃ面白くないというか、印象に残らないので、まあ普段は あまり見えないけど、こう立ち上がった時に見えるこう体のお腹の部分の黄色い色味だったり、まあそういったところにちゃんとこう色を入れて、こうちょっと立ち上がった時に印象的な色が出てくるっていうようなことも考えてデザインして
ます。Yeah, for I guess for Nergigante, right? They want to go with a you know cool color for this you know main monster. He is supposed to be you know the flagship monster for this title. So they decide, okay, we're gonna make him black because that looks pretty cool. But they realize, you know, if they just make him just black.Then that's also not very interesting. So, for you know, for most of his hide, you can see that it's black. But then, you know, when you see him rear up on his hind legs, you can see the yellow on his underbelly. You can see all this color. So you can see like you know, it just kind of comes at you at the most unexpected time. So you know, for them that was a very interesting like you know, way to change things up.
I love the armor variations of Nergigante's armor.I think it's very different and very cool.
Between male and female?
A and B.
A and B?
Yeah, alpha, beta.
なんかヌルギガンテの防具、なんかアルファとベータのなんか違いはすごい面白いと。
あ、はい。ありがとうございます。
Thank you.
So, ヌルギガンテ was a pretty tough fight, but I feel like it was fair. Mike Mamone wants to know if there's ever a monster that ended up being so difficult in testing that you had to nerf it in the final game.
彼女はヌルギガンテと、戦闘して、まあ、難しいけどフェアな、うん、バトルだと思いますけど、うん、まあ、ユーザーが、モンスターが、うん、難しすぎて、うん、弱化しなければならないことがありますか、
うん
まあ、弱化なんか調整、
ああはい調整ね、うん、はいねありますね、結構、うん、あります。プケプケとかねめちゃくちゃ強かったんですよ最初。そのコンセプト通りに実装して、 完成しましたってなって、初めてテストプレイした時にやっぱ尻尾も伸びるし毒も出すしでめちゃくちゃ強かったんですよ。
Yeah, there's actually been a lot of cases of this, in particular in World. Puke Puke was a little bit too strong when they finally implemented the monster. You know, the monster was actually, you know, working as intended, but, you know, the monster can spit poison at you. It can do things with its tails, and they realized, wow, this is a little bit too much.
で、ただやっぱり、Puke Puke はどっちかというとこう序盤の、あのアクションに慣れてもらうためのチュートリアル的なモンスターの位置づけだったので、やっぱその、 その強さ自体はすごくいいんだけど、それをそのまま、実装すると、まあその序盤のモンスターとしては強すぎるので、そういった強さは上位になってからにしよう、で下位の段階ではそのもっとそのプケプケのそういう強いところをもうちょっとスポイルして、もう少しこう遊びやすいモンスターに、調整した。
Yeah, so they figured like, yeah, Puke Puke was just a little bit too strong for what it was supposed to do in the game. And actually, its role in the game is to help new players get used to the battle system. And that's its kind of like, you know, role. It's supposed to teach you how to fight and, you know, what to do in this new environment. And for it to be too strong, you know, it wouldn't fulfill that duty. So what they did was they actually made that Puke Puke from the original concept.They made that into the high rank Puke Puke, and then they took that high rank Puke Puke and then toned it down so that it could actually fulfill its role as, you know, kind of the quote unquote tutorial monster.
なのでまあ大体のモンスターはやっぱプレイヤーに対してプレッシャーをかける部分っていうのを持たないといけないと思ってるから、最初の初期段階かなやっぱちょっと強めにやっぱ作ります。そういったユーザーにどういったプレッシャーをかけるモンスターなのかっていうのを分かりやすくするために、やっぱり少し強めには、設計して、それが見えた時にそういった要素を残しながらちょっとこう弱く調整していくっていうことをします。
Yeah, so they actually do start off with trying to make monsters pretty tough and challenging, and then, you know, from there they, you know, they make sure that, okay, everything isWork as intended, and maybe, you know, it might be a little bit too strong. So from, you know, from that vantage point, they decide, okay, what can we, you know, do or make our adjustments to make this monster a little bit more fair.
What? I felt like the progression in Monster Hunter World was very fair and worked very well. I didn't come to very many hard walls unless I felt like it was supposed to be a hard wall.While playing Monster Hunter World, did you fight any monster that was particularly difficult for you?
World では、言われる、壁のモンスター、あまり超えないモンスターが、いると思いますけど、藤岡さんには、そういうなんか壁のモンスターがありましたか、
ワールドで、そうですね、やっぱり防具作らないとまずいかなって最初に思ったのはアンジャナフあたりは、やっぱりちょっとこうグッと一段階強くなってくるところがあるなと思っているので、やっぱアンジャナフあたりでは一回ちゃんと防具のことを考えました。
Yeah, so I guess the first time he thought, okay, you know, I'm gonna have toMake some new equipment and whatnot was probably around Angela. That was kind of, same thing as Keith. Please don't, I guess. Yeah, so basically, yeah, Angela was basically the first wall for him where he thought, okay, you know, I'm doing okay, but, you know, I can't really get past this monster, so I'm going to have to make something new so that I can battle this.
なので僕はリオレイヤーとかやっぱり慣れてるのもあるし、結構遊んでて、長遊びも楽しいので。リオレイヤーの装備まず作ってとかそういうのをやりました。
Yeah, so what he did was he went for Rathian armor.
Wow.
Because, you know, he's already used to the Rathian fight, so he, you know, he could make that pretty quickly. And he thought, okay, you know, because I know this fight, you know, it shouldn't be too difficult for me.
We're just almost out of time, so I'm gonna ask two more questions.
あと2問。
2問、はい。
And the first one is a from Nathan Huss on Twitter asks, what are your best tips for new Monster Hunter players?
初めてのモンハンプレイヤーに、
はい、
アドバイス、
はいはい、
ちょっと伝えてもらって
そうですね、アクションとかちょっと慣れてない人はやっぱどうしても、モンスターの攻撃を食らってしまうことが多いと思うので、なるべくその、防具とかの、その今回結構いろんな防具作っても必ずスキルも出るし、なんか、なんだろうな、いろいろ作ってこうバラバラの装備を着てても結構スキルも出てるし防御力もしっかり上がるので、あまりこうなんだろうな、一個集めようとせずとも作れるものをどんどん作っていって、とにかく防御力を最初はちょっとこう上げよう上げようとプレイした方が死ににくいしいいんじゃないかなとは思ってます。
Yeah, so Fujuka-san thinks that, you know, maybe for new players, they want to take a look at the, kind of the armor skills that each of the armor parts have. And that can really help you out with if you have any monster that you're having difficulty with. Even if, you know, you're just going to make like one piece from one armor piece from one monster, one armor piece from another monster, that's okay. You know, so long as, you know, you can get your defense up, you can get the proper skills, that's all that matters if, you know, you're having trouble with the game.
で、あとはモンスターハンターにあまり慣れてない人は、モンスターのこのとのやり取り結構独特なものがモンスターハンターってあると思うので、あまりこう頭側に立たないようにして、やっぱり頭側、モンスターの頭側というすごい強力な攻撃をたくさん持ってるやつらが多いので、うん、とにかくそのなるべくその頭側に立たずに後ろ側をキープしようとしてアクションしてもらえるとクリアしやすくなってくると思う。
So, for people who aren't used to Monster Hunter, we advise you not to stand in front of the monster near its head. That's probably the worst thing you can do because a lot of monsters in this game, they have a lot of attacks that are going to hit your head on like this. And as you can see, wrapping here, it has, you know, a tail flip and whatnot. So, Fujioka-san thinks that, you know, if you can stay away from its head, go to other places around the monster,You're gonna have a much easier time clearing each quest.
Diablos.
Oh, yeah, it's Diablos. Oh, oh.
Diablos.
Uh
oh.
Oh, Yuri, you're in trouble. Oh, there's Barof also.
Oh, man.
Yuri, challenge.
You wanna go for Yuri?
Go Yuri.
Go Yuri. There you go.
Are you not? No. Go Yuri.
Go, go, go.
Oh, it's a.
Mobros mo.
Diablos, yes. Hi.
モンプロス。
あ、モンプロスいる。すごい状態だ。
Good luck.
Have fun, dude.
So, last question comes from Twitter user Shadow001 asks, how does it feel to have directed a game so eagerly anticipated by such a massive player base?
世界が期待してたタイトルを予約、ね、発売して、今の気持ちはどう、
今ですか。はい。予約世界中の方にの手に届くようになったのは本当に僕自身もすごく嬉しいし、なんだろうな、このゲームにこういうゲームを作ろうっていうのを決めてからかなりいろんなことをテストしたりとか、こういう技術的な部分を学びながら作ったので、なんだろうな、ようやくここまでできて形にできたっていうのは、本当にすごく嬉しいですね、本当に。はい。で、このモンスターワールドがスタート地点だと思ってるので、これをまた たくさん楽しんでもらいたいなと思ってます。
Yeah, he feels nothing but happiness for having this game finally come out. And, you know, the team, we actually, you know,They spent a lot of time testing this game, making sure that everything went right. They also had, a lot of technical things that they had to overcome. And, you know, to finally have this game come out in the hands of fans is, you know, he just feels nothing but happiness right now. And he's hoping that, you know, everyone who's playing right now, they're going to look forward to, you know, stuff that we'll have for them in the future too.
でも、本当に、非常にいいリアクションを今たくさんもらってるので、ちょっと 安心してます。
Actually, he's also seen, you know, a lot of the、reactions online from fans. He's also seen a lot of reviews, and he's very, very relieved that everyone really enjoys the game right now.
Again, thank you so much for tuning in to our Monster Hunter World Let's Play with the executive director of Monster Hunter World, Fujioka-san. You can also check out our very positive review of Monster Hunter World right here on IGN. Again, this is Casey DeFreitas. You can find me at ShinyKCD, and I'm sure you can find Yuri, Andrew, and Fujioka-san on Twitter.If you'd like to find them. Thanks a lot. Have a great day. Happy hunting.